Assalamualaikum, this is Sumaira Tahir and you are watching Trainers Empower. I hope everybody is doing great. This video is in English on popular demand, so more people will gonna get benefit from this video. Today's video's topic is 10 things your sales agents or the insurance agents will never gonna tell you about. Insurance agents, number one, always recommend you to buy endowment life insurance plans. Why? Because they know that people are in a hurry to buy at the month end or at the end of the fiscal year to save on taxes. These insurance plans are insurance come saving plans. So the cost is high. If you want to provide your family with a minimum cost, these endowment plans are not for you. Never mix insurance with investment. These insurance plans have the element of investment as well. Number second, most of the insurance agents, they're never gonna tell you about, you know, when you receive your policy documents, you should go to your beneficiary or tell your beneficiaries that you have purchased an insurance plan for them and they can take the claim benefit. Number three, they will never gonna tell you about the surrender value of the plans. What will be the surrender value at different times? So it is never recommended to surrender your policy at the early stage of your plan. If you surrender your policy, let's say at the second, third or fourth year, you might get nothing out of it or a very low amount. So your sales agents will never gonna tell you about this. Number four, sales agents never recommend buying term life insurance plans because they get little or no commission from those term life insurance plans. Number five, your insurance agent always tell you about the maturity value of the plan rather than showcasing the actual rate of return within internal rate of return, net present value of different benefits at different times and comparing with the initial investment. So what is number six? Number six is agents always hides or neglect talking about the critical clauses or exclusions of the policy. Those clauses and exclusions are very, very important. Either non-disclosure or wrong disclosure can lead to claim rejection, and which is not good for your beneficiary. For example, if you have a certain health condition and you didn't reveal about that condition in the proposal form or to the insurer, that might lead to claim rejection as well. So reading those exclusions are very important. For example, one exclusion is most of the insurance companies don't cover the terrorist attack, I mean death by terrorist attack. Number seven, let's see what is number seven. Insurance agents will never mention buying online plans. These days, most of the companies have gone online and most of the plans are available online. But insurance agents will never gonna mention you buying online. Why? Because they will not gonna get anything. Because the operational costs of the insurance companies are minimum or very low for online products, for online plans. Whereas if you are buying offline, you are talking with the agent, you are dealing with the sales agent, they have to pay that agent certain amount. They have to pay for the administrative and operational costs as well. So purchasing online is much more cheaper as compared to buying offline insurance plans. Number 8. So what's number 8? Number 8 is free look period. Your sales agents or most of the sales agents will never going to tell you about the free look period. What is free look period and what can you do about it? Basically, a free look period is a 14 or 15 day period depending from company to company, in which when you get the policy documents in mail, you have 14 or 15 days to study, to go through those policy documents. And if you feel that this is not what you want and these are not the benefits which will be right for your family, you have 14 days to cancel your policy documents and you can ask for refund from the insurance company. Number 9, no medical examination is required. Your sales agents or the insurance agents will always gonna tell you that you don't need a medical examination. But I would always suggest to go for a medical test. Number 1, these medical examination is free of cost if you are buying an insurance plan. Secondly, it's very important to go for a medical test if you don't want any problem for your beneficiaries, because if there is a medical condition, you hide from the company, or if something comes up when your beneficiary is going for the claim, the company might reject the claim. But if you have gone for a medical test and they see there is no pre-existing condition, and that condition has, if there is certain condition that comes out after buying a life insurance plan, your beneficiary will not gonna have any problem in settling a claim with the insurance company. Number 10. What is number 10? Number 10 is your life insurance agents will always gonna tell you, oh, don't worry about paying the premium. You can pay monthly, you can pay quarterly, but let me tell you, if you pay the premiums monthly or quarterly, you are paying so many installments and you will not gonna get discount out of them. So paying monthly or quarterly is not recommended. It's best in your interest to buy annual plans or semi-annual plans. Let's end the video here. Thank you so much for watching me. Thank you so much for your comments. In the end, I would like to thank everyone for liking my videos, for subscribing my channel, for your comments, for your suggestions, for your prayers. Guys, take a very good care of yourselves and please avoid going to the public places and try to do most of the things from home. Because of this third wave of corona, we have to take care of yourselves and for the benefit of our families, for our loved ones, we have to limit our social contact to a minimum level. You have all the gadgets you need. You have televisions, you have mobiles, you have your laptops. Go for a Zoom meeting, or you can go on a Messenger and chat with your friends, and you can have a video conference with your friends and family. But please avoid going to the public places and where there is a chance of interacting so many people. So in the end, I just want to say I hope that everybody will gonna stay safe. And always remember me in your prayers. Allah Hafiz. Goodbye. See you.